Hi, I'm Rich from RIVCO Products. Today we're going to show you how to install a trailer hitch on a 2014 or newer Harley-Davidson FLH or FLD model. And that would include classics, ultra classics, limiteds, road king, street glide, road glide, and all CVO or Screaming Eagle versions of those same bikes. When you get the trailer hitch, in fact the components are those main pieces, they're the main part of the hitch. Called the struts that connect the bottom of the hitch to the main frame of the bike, the tongue, which your ball will mount to, the hardware, and of course the instructions. The particular bike we're working on today is a 2015 Ultra. Other models may be slightly different. You may or may not have a tour pack or a backrest. Again, this is a 2015 Ultra. It fits up all the FLH and FLD models. The first thing to do is remove the backrest if it has one, remove the seat and the saddlebags. Once we've got the seat and saddlebags off, the next step, if the model was equipped with a backrest, we're going to take the backrest mounting bracket off. And that's a couple of 7/16 nuts and bolts. This on the classics and the ultra classics, the limiteds will all have the backrest on them. There's two nuts there. You'll notice in this gold mounting bracket that there's four different mounting positions. Take note of where that's at so we can put that back together. You have it in the same spot. Usually the nuts will make a little mark there, so it's pretty easy to tell. So there's two nuts back there on the fender, and a third bolt here. All 7/16 wrenches and sockets, the bracket will come off. Then we're going to unplug the taillight wires that go through the fender from the main wiring harness. On street glide and road glide, that'll be underneath the side cover. On all other models, it'll be here underneath the seat. So to do that, we press the little clip, plug the taillight wires from the fender. Some models will have the clip attached to the fender. You get that off, use a small blade screwdriver. It's a little clip there, pry out on the clip, pull the connector off from the rear fender. The next step is to remove the small clips that hold the saddlebag to the main frame. The little gold plated clip here comes out using a blade screwdriver, pry that clip outward, put it down on it, and it'll slide off the frame. Get that off on both sides. Gain access to some bolts right behind there. If your model is equipped with a tour pack like this Ultra, the tour pack is going to come off with the bracket or rack that it mounts to. To do that, we're going to disconnect all the wires down below. There's a few cable ties here usually from the factory that hold those wires to the frame. You're going to cut those cable ties. We're going to unplug the wires, take the little clips off like we did for the fender, and then to get the tour pack off, there's four T40 Torx bolts, two on each side right here. We're going to take the rear two out first, we're going to loosen the front two, and then it'll help greatly if you have a friend or helper that can hold on to that tour pack and lift it off while you take the last two screws out. It can be done on your own, a little easier to help. So we've got all the wires disconnected here that go to the tour pack. We've undone that, the cable ties, we've taken the wire clips off of the frame. We've got the two T40 Torx bolts out on both sides. You notice the tour pack will still sit there on its own. Like I said, it helps a little bit to have a helper, but you'll lift this up. Tour pack will come right off the bike, set that aside on the ground. Now that we've got the tour pack off, if your model was equipped with that, we're going to take off what's called the inner fender support bracket. If you put your hand up here and look inside, you'll see there's a heavy chrome bracket that follows the inside of the fender and connects the right saddlebag support to the left. We're going to take that bracket out. That's not going to be reused. Our trailer hitch is going to fit in and take the place of that. So to remove that, not the outer, but on the inside here, you see there's two bolts, T40 Torx on one side and a half inch nut on the other. We're going to remove those two, one from each side. And that's the majority of what holds that in. The bike, once that's off, in the center, if your model is equipped with a bumper like this, you look underneath the fender in the center, you see there's a 7/16 nut that holds part of the taillight on and a little wire clip there. So we're going to take the 7/16 nut off the inside of the fender here holding the wire clip and possibly the bumper if you have a bumper in your model. So the next step is we're going to remove the rear fender to put the hitch up into. And to do that, we're going to follow, we're going to remove several bolts along here that hold the rear fender on, starting with the two large 3/8 bolts, 9/16 wrench, T40 Torx. We're going to loosen these. Okay, we're not going to remove these actually, we're going to just loosen them up 2 to 3 turns, give us a little clearance for play. And we're going to remove the T40 Torx bolts the rear here. They're exposed, as you see easily, both sides. The fender still won't come out. There's still one hole. Then we're going to remove the forward bolts right through the hole we moved the clip earlier. These bolts hold the front rear fender in place. We're going to remove these bolts. Both sides. So we've loosened the large bolts with the T40 Torx. We've removed the ones that are exposed that you see. We've removed the two front fender mounting bolts. Now we're going to remove this seat strap bracket bolts here. The model may or may not have these. As we do that, you'll see what we call the foam fender support here. It's very loose. The only thing really holding that on is the bolt on the bottom down there. But we're good with that. Okay, those loose. The last thing to do for the fender to come out and down, there's two more Torx 40 bolts. The final ones that hold the fender in here are going to be two that are hidden right back in here. It may help you a little bit to have somebody else there to assist you and pull the last bolt out. You'll also notice that these bolts get a little tricky coming out of the hole there. They like to fall out of there. That one. Front of the fender goes down there. Now, before this bolt comes out, the last couple of threads, I'm going to kind of hold that up with my hand. Again, you may want to have somebody help you do that. Last T40. Bring that out of the hole, the whole fender. So get you out of there. You come down a little bit. I'll rotate that to the rear, pull the little chrome brackets apart. You'll see a large nut there on the fender. Fender out in between that. Be a little careful, you don't want to scratch the paint even though it's not where you want to see it. You rotate that fender way down, and we're rotating it way down, and this is the reason we're up on the 2x4s. It's the two four nuts here, the last two nuts have to come underneath the frame. So rotate that fender way down, pull it out of there. So now we've got the fender off the motorcycle. We're going to take the two nuts off here on both sides. And you'll notice I have this on a towel. It's a good idea to put on a towel or a rug so we don't scratch the paint anywhere. Use a 3/4 inch wrench. We're going to take these nuts off, the rear nuts, not the forward ones, from both sides of the rear fender. Flip the fender over. Once you've got those loose, take that off, both sides. You'll notice that the bolt is really hollow. It's threaded on the inside. That's one of the bolt holes that holds that fender on there. The hitch is going to replace that. The clip we took off earlier, we're going to put that clip back on, and then we're going to put the nut washer back on there and snug that back up. We don't need that anymore. We'll hold the wire in place. If your model is a street glide or a road glide, it's at this point that you're going to take out the original tail light here, which is a very deep box, and replace that with a much thinner tail light that gives you clearance for the trailer hitch. And that's on street glide and road glide models. You have that tail light and the lower fender built into the valance. Okay, so we've got that back in. Now we're going to take the trailer hitch frame. This is what's replacing that inside fender support that we took out earlier. That's replacing those T-nuts. We're going to put that in one side, and we're going to flex the other side in. Slide right there, goes into there. The hitch is going to rest back inside the frame there like that. And we are going to put the two nuts and the washers back on. And again, like I said, you notice that wasn't super tight when you took that apart, so we're not going to tighten the daylights out of these. If you over-tighten them, you stand a chance of breaking that hollow threaded stud off. You want about 5 to 10 foot-pounds of torque is all you really need on that. Pretty snug, like I said. Oh, the other bolt that goes through the center of that, if it really does the work, and holds that to the frame. Okay, your hitch is on, your fender's ready to go back into the bike. So we've got the trailer hitch installed inside the fender. We're going to install the fender back into the bike. It helps to have another person hold up the front of this fender for you and get this little bolts lined up for you. We're going to spread the two chrome rails apart one at a time, put those nuts inside of the frame and the supports. We're going to rotate the fender forward. We're going to make sure the air line for your air shocks is above the fender. We're also going to make sure in there, that the trailer hitch is behind the chrome support. We're going to lift this straight up in place. My friend here is going to hold the front of that up there for me.
get this in between the frame. Now notice how the hitch is behind the chrome support. That's where it's got to be. We're going to use one of our T40 Torx bolts. We're putting these, the rear fender support bolts, right back here. That hole's kind of difficult to see. If you look from the top down though, you'll see that that's pretty easy to align. First one in there, just going to get those started. Put the same thing in on the other side. Alright, thank you, friend. Just got our airline up on top, that's where we want to be. Here, wires there. Okay, our next step is going to be put the front fender support bolts in. It's going to require pushing the fender in the rear down. Come up a little bit here at the front. Eyeball that through the hole. And check your airline. That airline should be to the rear of the fender nut here. That's where I got it, to the rear. You don't have that pinched in there. Lift our fender up. Get the forward bolts in there and started. There's the forward one. The fender reinstalled with four main fender bolts back in there, making sure the wires are up above the fender, the hose is above the fender. We haven't pinched the hose inside, we're putting the bolts in the side. The bolt's just finger tight. We're going to reinstall the tour pack if your model has that. And you might want to have somebody give me an image. You can do it yourself. Be careful here so you don't damage your fender. It's going to go right inside of that slot. Front goes down in there first. It hooks in a little bit. It'll just sit there on its own. We've got a couple of hooks there, so you can get that in there on your own. We're going to put two of the T40 screws back in there. And the rear bolts only. It's going to be these two right here. Okay, that's the two of those. Then we're going to install the supplied struts. You'll notice these struts are marked right and left down here in the bottom. The strut's going to go on as follows. It goes to the front of the saddlebag support and frame support there, like so. It's going to bolt on right here. We're going to use new hardware supply. There are some longer and shorter 5/16 bolts. We're going to use the longer bolts. Lock washer, washer, one of the spacers, aluminum spacers supplied. Again, we're going to make sure we've got the right side. Bolt the washer through the strut, spacer on, and we're going to go into the hole for the front of the tour pack there. Get those holes lined up there and get that started. Threads into that. We're good. At the bottom of that strut, again, we're going to use a washer and a nut. Both sides, we're going to use the washer here. We're going to start with the washer. We're going to go from the rear to the front. We should be going through the trailer hitch, the support. We're going to go forward to the strut. Put another washer and an eye-lock nut. Alright, we're going to get to that same point on the other side. Okay, with the tour pack reinstalled, the rear bolts first, and then the struts installed loosely. We got the front bolts in there with the spacers behind them. Right-hand strut, marked right on the right side. The strut to the front with the saddlebag support and the frame here, rail here. And then we've used the new longer bolts at the top, the lock washers and washers, the shorter bolts, washers first, bolts, washers again, and the supplied lock nuts. Last thing we're going to install here, that we removed earlier, the two Allen head T40 drive Torx bolts.
get those loosely installed. Get all these bolts started and tighten everything down, we're done. It's these two. After these two, we're going to install the seat strap brackets. That's started in there. Seat strap brackets removed earlier. We're going to install those. Tighten everything up. Reach underneath, take a look. You should be able to just about stick your finger between the tire and the trailer hitch on both sides. Check that that distance is equal on both sides. Okay, feels good, like it should. Now we're gonna go back. We're gonna tighten down the large 3/8 bolts here with the T40s. We're gonna tighten the new inner bolts here on the strut. We're gonna tighten the rear fender, the front fender bolts. We're gonna tighten the 4 bolts for the tour pack, the remaining fender bolt, and the bolt for our seat strap. So make sure you've got all the bolts tight here. The forward fender bolts, the rear fender bolts, the tour pack bolts, the new bolts for the strut, the lower bolts for the strut, the fender support, retighten the large bolts here, the saddlebag supports, your seat strap bolts, if your model has that. Double check all those bolts, make sure you're tight there. Put pretty much everything back on for the hitch and the fender. The clips go back in, your saddlebag. Pin clips slide right onto the frame there, click into place. Put our wiring back in place. All the wires to our tour pack. We're going to reconnect all those, put the clips back to the frame, put a cable tie back onto the frame. We're going to put our taillight wires back together. Get all of those clipped back in where they belong. Once you've got your trailer hitch installed, you'll need wiring to supply power for the lights on your trailer. At RIVCO, we make a complete line of plug-and-play components to make that easy for you. The first thing you'll need is a sub-harness for your bike, and that makes an easy plug-in connection to the motorcycle. You'll unplug the taillight or tour pack wires, plug this in line, and you'll have the outgoing power to your trailer with no cutting, no splicing. The next thing you'll need is what's called an isolator. On 2014 and newer Harley-Davidsons, you have CAN bus computerized wiring. There are 2 issues with that. One is it uses a very small gauge wire that cannot flow enough power to give you all the power you need for full brightness to your taillight wires on the trailer. The other is that the computer senses the additional load and will give you fault codes for a flashing yellow light on the dash. So to eliminate those 2 problems, an isolator will connect to your battery through a fuse, and when you turn on the key, turn on the taillights, the turn signals, the brakes, it will supply the power from the battery directly through this unit to the trailer and give you full amperage and voltage, and the computer system can't sense that it's there. So that will take care of both your computer system and the fact that you don't have heavy enough wire to run the taillights directly. So from there, you'll add whatever plug you need to go on your trailer on the other end of that. As there are several different plugs, we do not supply that. The other thing you may need optionally is what's called a 4-to-5 wire converter. On 2014 and newer Harley Davidsons, they use a 4 wire combined brake and turn signal stop system, so that you do not need to have any additional wiring if your trailer is 4 wire. If you have a 5 wire trailer, this item is called a 4-to-5 wire signal decoder. It changes the signal from 4 wires going in to 5 wires coming out. If you require that, and we're going to do that on this particular motorcycle, that plugs in line after the sub-harness. The sub-harness plugs in first, then the decoder, the isolator, the plug on the other end. We'll show you how this goes on the motorcycle. Each of the components we manufacture for the trailer light wiring will include a very simple to follow wiring diagram like this. And there are 2 basic setups. First is the 4-wire system, second is a 5-wire system. 2014 and newer Harley-Davidsons have a 4-wire system already on the motorcycle. So what we need to do is install the sub-harness to make the plug-in connection to the bike without any splicing. From there, we'll plug into that the isolator, which takes all the power directly from the battery and supplies it to the trailer. It plugs in, it has a ground wire, a positive wire with a fuse that's going to go to the battery. On the output side, there'll be a ground, a taillight wire, a combined left turn and stop, and a combined right turn and stop. There'll be an additional green wire, we're not going to use that. If the motorcycle trailer you will be towing is a 5-wire system,
you will have also the sub-harness. From there, you will need to add the decoder box that changes the 4-wire signal to a 5-wire signal. That is a ground wire. It must be grounded out before the ignition is turned on or the unit could be damaged. The decoder box is then plugged into the isolator, which again supplies the power directly from the battery to the trailer's lighting. That has ground, the positive. This has a ground wire coming out, a green for stop, a brown for tail, an orange for left turn, and a blue for right turn. So those signals are separated into 5 wires. From there, on either one, you'll add whatever plug matches your trailer. So let's install the trailer wire. This is the 2015 Ultra. On 2014 and newer models, it is a 4-wire system, and it uses a plug that looks like this, a male and a female plug. On some models, that plug is going to be right by the rear fender here. That's going to be models that do not have a tour pack. Other models with a tour pack, the plug will be right in front of the tour pack, at the rear where the seat meets the tour pack. The way to tell that we have the correct plug is, we're going to unplug the one we think we need. From there, we'll turn the ignition on, and you want to verify that you do not have turn signals working. So I do not have any turn signals. Notice I have the lower tail light, but I do not have turn signals. That's correct. If you still have turn signals, you are on the wrong plug. From there, we're going to plug the sub-harness into the motorcycle. It's a male and female connection. You'll notice on these that two of these wires are not used. You should have numbers 1 and 6 not used as it comes from the factory. 2, 3, 4, and 5 are used. The two unused wires are swapped out for some earlier models you'll see in the instructions. But for 14 and newer, you use it just as it comes. So in this particular model, we're going to make that connection, plug that in, plug the other end in here. Now we've got the connection to our motorcycle made with no cutting or splicing. From there, this particular customer has a 5-wire trailer, so from there we're going to put in the 4-to-5 signal decoder. That again plugs in line. That has a ground wire. That ground wire must be attached to a good ground on the frame or the battery before the ignition is turned back on. From there, we're going to use the isolator. The isolator plugs into that. Now if you had a 4-wire trailer, you wouldn't be putting this decoder in line, you would be plugging the isolator right into that sub-harness. So we'll plug that in line. That also has a ground. What I like to do is connect that ground to the same place I do on the frame. There'll be a red positive wire. There's a fuse comes with it. You want to connect this fuse to the battery. Cut the wire to the length you need. Connect that. On this particular model, on Ultra, there's plenty of room right here underneath the seat backrest support. I like to put those components right in there and cable tie those in place. I'll show you that in a minute. Other models, you will fit underneath the seat. From there, you have the output wires. You're going to go down to your trailer ball, and we're going to put a plug on that. So we've got all the wiring plugged in. We secured everything nicely with the double case tape that's supplied, both the decoder box, the isolator. If you don't have this particular arrangement with the backrest, it'll fit in front of the battery, or there's remaining room just under the seat, very near the fender. Tri-glides, there's plenty of room underneath the seat to install all these components and secure them. So we've cable tied it all down. We've taken the wires coming out to the trailer, routed them between the frame and the fender, and come out along the strut back here, cable tied it securely. This is a 5-wire system, so we're using a 6-wire molded plug. We flipped one of the wires that we're not going to use. We've made our connections using butt connectors, staggered the connections, if you'll notice, so that you don't end up with all the connectors in one place with a big lump in your wire harness. We can then put the sheath back on. We're going to route that back underneath, and we'll have the plug we need for our trailer. The other thing, when you're not used to towing the trailer, you can stow the plug up in between the saddlebag support rail here. You might have to take the bag off if you'd like, but it can be stowed in this manner. Some people will have a piece of Velcro to it. Velcro it in place right here when it's not in use. That's up to you. We recommend the free plug here on the wire versus ones that mount to the ball. If it attaches to the ball, you can't remove the tongue. So the last step, putting everything back together again, was make sure all your wires are plugged back into the tour pack if you had that. Your fender lights are plugged in, the clips are on. Your seat backrest support bracket, if you have one, that's installed. Mechanically, that's pretty much the full installation of the hitch. Let's take a look at the tongue back here. It
talk about that. The tongue is your basic vertical receiver type. It's going to go back up into there. There's three different holes. Really, that's designed for this particular model. It does not have any type of lower valance. Other models will have a tubular bumper on them. Some models will have the lower valance with the lights in it on the Street Glide, Road Glide. You use the different holes for that, or if your trailer is even lower. But basically, you're going to just slide that tongue up inside of there, put the pin in, and when you install that, you want the clip to be to the front side. You'll see that obviously if that clip's to the rear, it's possible for that to rub on the fender. We don't want that. So there's the clip. There's two safety chain holes here for you. There's also a bolt at the front we call an anti-rattle bolt. You can tighten that bolt up, keep the tongue from doing this number when you're going down the road. Some people find that annoying and want that tight. That pretty much concludes it. Put on whatever ball you need. So we have our saddlebags back on. We have the wire harness out where we like it, enough slack to reach our trailer, and that's connected. One of the things we need to store this plug is the little Velcro around the plug itself. A little piece of Velcro on the side of the fender. So if you're not using that, you can tuck that right up out of the way. This is the RIVCO Parade Flag Holder. This is made to mount to any motorcycle that has a trailer hitch, or motorcycles without a trailer hitch. You can make brackets for some Harley-Davidson and Honda Goldwing. You can mount this without a trailer hitch. But with this bracket, it can be mounted to any trailer hitch. When you get the flag holder, it will include a single tube or socket, we call it, to hold one flag. It has two additional holes. You can bolt two on in the opposite holes, or you can have three all the way across. Let's show you this on a motorcycle. Here's a 2015 Harley-Davidson with a trailer hitch on it. We've bolted our HWK rack and flag mounting bracket to the tongue. Straddling the tongue, we bolted that on with the ball. Now, if your trailer hitch is wider than this, or it's called a platform type hitch, you can flip this bracket over. You can mount it on top of the trailer hitch in this direction. You can put it underneath the trailer hitch. Either way, it doesn't matter. Once that's installed, all you do is put the flag holder into the two tubes, install the two clips that come with it. It's a couple of locking clips here, go right into the holes. You got a flag holder, one, two, or three parade flags. We also make for this the flag poles. We make two different styles of flag poles. We make an aluminum flag pole that is telescoping, and this one is made for around town, 25, 30 mile an hour type speeds. It's 6.5 feet tall. It very simply just twist locks. Comes down to about 14 inches when you're not using it. Tow it in your saddlebag. You don't have to take the flag off. You telescope it out. All of our flag poles use a very unique little clip that allows you to put the flag on, set the height of the clip, have it stay sturdy in place without worrying about the flag sagging down on you, unfurling, any of that. So you can have that up in a jiff. It goes right in your flag holder like that. There's no pin, no bolting, no securing necessary. Just the wind pressure on it alone to keep that in place. Again, this is good for in town, 20, 30 miles an hour. Not recommended for highway speeds. We make a heavier duty flag pole. This is all stainless construction. It's three pieces, screws together like a cue stick. Comes with a sewn bag that the three pieces fit in to store them. This will fit into any Harley-Davidson trunk or saddle bag. And then Honda Goldwings, with many other bikes, the three sections come apart. You simply screw them together. Again, you can leave the clips installed. This one, when you unscrew the three sections, you'll want to take that flag off. Again, that fits right down into the holder securely. And like I said, all of our flags come with a very nice clipping system that can snap the clip. The flag is off of there that quick. Now, this is a RIVCO 11 by 17 quick detach rack. This rack is made to go into any motorcycle's trailer hitch with the use of this bracket that's included with the rack. You simply take the ball off of your hitch, bolt the bracket on with the ball, both together at the same time. This can go on top of the tongue, as you see here. It can go below the tongue. It can be turned over on top. Once that's installed, you simply slide the rack into the brackets. It has two retaining clips go in to hold it in place securely. We make a matching duffel bag to go on the back of this that locks on with two locking rods. We
We also make a tail light assembly that bolts onto this, that plugs into your trailer hitch. If you've got a motorcycle like this where your tail light is obscured, this motorcycle has tail lights and turn signals and brake lights in the trunk or tour pack, but you can also add that tail light to the back. Some models won't have that and you'll need to have the additional tail lights. Again, this RIVCO's quick detach rack. That rack is rated to hold 35 pounds of weight, but it easily will support 200 pounds without a problem.